Recorded Books presents an unabridged recording of Mr. Putter and Tabby Pick the Pears by Cynthia Rylant, narrated by John McDonough.
Chapter 1. Pear Jelly. It was fall, and juicy things were growing in Mr. Putter's backyard. Juicy apples, juicy tomatoes, juicy pears. Mr. Putter walked with his fine cat, Tabby, among the juicy things, and he dreamed. He dreamed of apple pie and apple turnovers. He dreamed of hot apple cider with a cinnamon stick and stuffed red tomatoes. But most of all, he dreamed of pear jelly. Mr. Putter loved pear jelly. He had loved it since he was a boy. Fall was his favorite season because of pear jelly. And now it was time. "Tabby," said Mr. Putter, "it is time to pick the pears." Tabby loved it when Mr. Putter said it was time to do something. She was old, but she still liked excitement. She followed Mr. Putter into the garage, where he found a ladder for pear picking. Then they went to the backyard, where all the excitement was. Chapter 2. Cranky Legs. Mr. Putter had a problem. It was a ladder problem. Mr. Putter set his ladder against the pear tree, but he couldn't get up the ladder. Last year he got up the ladder, but this year he had cranky legs. Cranky legs, cranky knees, cranky feet. He stepped onto the ladder, and his legs were so cranky he had to get right off again. "One trouble with being old," said Mr. Putter, "is being cranky." Tabby knew what he meant. She had a cranky tail. Some days it was so cranky it wouldn't swish. It just stuck in the air like a stick. Cranky legs and cranky tails are no fun when you're old, especially if you want pear jelly. Mr. Putter looked at the pears still in his tree, and he thought. He thought and thought and thought. Tabby curled herself up and waited. She liked excitement, but she could wait for it. Chapter 3. Zing. "What I need," said Mr. Putter at last, "is a good slingshot." Mr. Putter knew about slingshots. He had played with them as a boy. They were good for knocking cans off logs, so they must be good for knocking pears off trees. Tabby followed him into the house to make a slingshot. Mr. Putter found a pair of old underwear that he didn't like. He didn't like it because it was covered with poodles. His brother had given him the underwear for his birthday. His brother loved the underwear. He thought it was funny. Mr. Putter did not. So he cut up the underwear and got some very good elastic. Then he got an old glove. Then he got a stick. And he made his slingshot. Mr. Putter and Tabby went back to the pear tree. Mr. Putter needed something hard and round to sling. Many of his apples had already fallen, so he picked up an apple. He put the apple in the slingshot. He aimed at a pear in the tree and pulled back as hard as he could. Zing! The hard, round apple...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.